أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يوم تأتي كل نفس تجادل عن نفسها وتوفى كل نفس ما عملت وهم لا يظلمون. صدق الله العظيم. Recall the day when every soul will come disputing on its own behalf, arguing in the defense for itself. وتوفى كل نفس. And every soul will be paid in full, ma amilat, whatsoever it would have done, whatsoever it would have earned, wahum la yuslamun, and they will not be wronged. وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strikes a similitude of a township which was at peace. قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً contented. يَعْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ. And all the requirements, the food, etc., used to come to it from all the places, from every place. فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ. Then it became ungrateful for the blessings of Allah. فَأَذَاقَ اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ. So Allah let it taste the garment of hunger and of fear. بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. Because of what they used to do. Regarding this simile, there are three views of the exegesis. One is that it is common, not a particular city or township mentioned here. The other is that it is the story of the nation of Saba in Yemen. And the third, which I prefer, is that here actually a similitude is given for Makkah itself. Makkah was at peace, no doubt, place of peace. Number two, the fruit from all the sides, from whole of the world coming to it. And it was so before also, just as it is today. But when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was, when he was appointed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to call the people of Makkah towards Tawheed, to believe in one God, to worship one God, and to believe in resurrection, and to take to the right path. And now the people refuse to accept him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for their chastisement, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala produced a famine over there. And that is actually mentioned over here, because it's the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَنُزِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent messenger to any nation, any people, any town, any city, he sent small, you know, chastisements so that the people should awaken, wake up, so that they now listen with attention to the call of the messenger of Allah before the final destruction. So that was the case at Makkah also. It is historically established. وَلَقَدْ جَاهُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْهُمْ. And a messenger had already come to them from among themselves. فَكَذَّبُوا. But they refused to accept him. They belied him. فَأَخَذَهُمُ الْعَذَابُ وَهُمْ ظَالِمُونَ. So the chastisement took over them, and they were the evil doers. فَكُلُوا مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهُ حَلَالًا طَيِّبًا. So, O mankind, you eat from whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided you, if it is lawful and clean. حَلَالًا طَيِّبًا. Whatever is lawful, not forbidden, not haram. طَيِّبًا, clean. إِن كُنْتُمْ إِيَّاهُ تَعْبُدُونَ. And you should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَشْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ إِيَّاهُ تَعْبُدُونَ. And for this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you these bounties, you should be thankful to Him if you really worship Him. إِنَّمَا حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَيْتَةَ وَالدَّمَ وَلَحْمَ الْخِنْزِيرِ وَمَا أُهِلَّ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ بِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden and declared haram for you four things. Number one, al-maita, the meat of the dead animal. Wadama. Number two, blood. Walam al-khinzir, and the flesh of swine. Wama uhilla lighairi Allahi bihi, and the meat of the animal which has been sacrificed for anybody else except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَمَنْ اِسْتُرَّ غَيْرَ بَاغٍ وَلَا عَادٍ. But whosoever is compelled by necessity, he is dying with hunger and he has nothing else to eat, for that is permissible for him, but with two conditions. غَيْرَ بَاغٍ, not craving for it. وَلَا عَادٍ, and not transgressing the minimum limit to keep alive, not more than that. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. So if a person is in such a distress and he has to use something from these four things which have been declared unlawful, haram, he can take something to save his life. وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَا تَصِفُ أَلْسِنَتُكُمُ الْكَذِبَ هَذَا حَلَالٌ وَهَذَا حَرَامٌ. And don't say with your tongues incorrectly that this is halal, permissible, and this is haram, this is forbidden. What does it mean? It's for Allah to decide what is halal, what is haram, what is forbidden, and what is permissible. لَتَفْتَرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبِ. Not that you should fabricate lies on Allah. You hold an opinion of your own and then say this is from Allah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَفْتَرُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبَ لَا يُفْلِحُونَ. Those who forge and lie against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will not be successful. Mata'un qaleel. This world is a little enjoyment, a place to live for some time. Walahum adhabun aleem. And then for them will be a very painful chastisement. Wa'ala alladhina hadu harramna ma qasasna alayka min qabl. As for those who became Jews, we had declared unlawful, forbidden them from some things which we have already narrated to you. وَعَوَذَلَمْنَاهُمْ. And we didn't wrong them. We didn't do anything wrong to them. وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَسْلِمُونَ. But they had been doing wrong to themselves. ثُمَّ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لِلَّذِينَ عَمِلُوا السُّوَى بِجَهَالَةٍ. Then your Lord is in favor of those who commit something bad, evil, in ignorance, not knowingly. ثُمَّ تَابُوا مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ. And then they apologize and repent after that. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ مِنْ بَعْدِهَا لَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Surely your Lord, after this, that after they have repented, so He is the forgiving and the merciful. إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ كَانَ أُمَّةً قَانِتًا لِلَّهِ حَنِيفًا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Verily, surely Ibrahim, عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا وَلَهِ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ, was an ummah. What does it mean? A leader, a model for whole humanity. Amma yawmo means to aim something. And from this is imam. So here this word umma is used in place of imam. Inni ja'iluka linnasi imama. That was the promise given to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, and we have it in the first part of Quran, in the 15th section of Surah Al-Baqarah. Inni ja'iluka linnasi imama. So here this word is used in place of imam. Inna Ibrahim kana ummatan qanitan lillah. He was the Imam, the leader, a model for the humanity. Obedient to Allah, Hanifan, upright man of pure faith. وَلَمْ يَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. And he was not from those who assigned partners and equals to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. شَاكِرًا لِأَنْعُمِهِ. He was grateful and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his blessings. اجتباهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has selected him, chosen him. وَهَدَاهُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمِ. And had guided him to the right path, straight path. وَآتَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً. And we gave him in this world also good blessings. وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And verily, surely, in the hereafter, he will be from among our righteous people. ثُمَّ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ. Then after him, we have revealed to you, we have sent down the revelation to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَنِتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. That you should follow the creed of Ibrahim, who was upright and of pure faith. وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. And he was not one of the associators. إِنَّمَا جُعِلَ السَّبْتُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ. The Sabbath was only appointed for those who differed concerning it. Actually, for them also, Friday was prescribed. This is given in a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But due to their mischief, they disliked Friday and they adopted Sabbath, Saturday. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, okay, it is fixed for you now. Innama ju'ila as-sabtu. The Saturday was fixed for those people, alal-lazina ikhtalafu fih, who had differed regarding it. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَا يَحْكُمُ بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فِي مَا كَانُوا فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ. And surely your Lord will judge between them on the day of judgment in all the matters in which they were differing. اُدْعُوا إِلَىٰ سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ وَالْمَوْعِزَةِ الْحَسَنَةِ وَجَادِلُمْ بِالَّتِي أَحْسَنْ. Now these last four ayat are very profound, very important, addressing directly Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions, his followers. Ayah 125, again I have to say the same verse, very profound. It gives us three levels of da'wah. Calling towards Allah, calling towards the straight path, calling towards the religion of Allah, deen of Allah. This calling has to be on one of the three levels. Number one, level of the intelligentsia, the intellectual minority. You can't impress them by sermons. No. They need arguments. So first of all, highest level of da'wah is with hikmah. اُدْعُوا إِلَىٰ سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ. Call towards the path of your Lord with wisdom, with knowledge, with arguments. Because when Quran asks others, هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Bring forth your arguments if you are true. Then others have also the right to demand arguments. So this is the highest level of the intelligentsia or the intellectual minority. Then come the level of the common people, whose minds are like clean slates. You can write on it. They don't have any philosophies in their mind. They don't know what is Marxism and what is existentialism and what is logical positivism, nothing of the sort. So you can approach their hearts directly. And to approach their hearts directly, good sermon. Mawizatil hasana. This is the second level. If it comes from your heart, it will descend on the heart of the person to whom you are calling. As dil khizat, bar dil rezat. Only you have to be sincere. Whatever you say out of sincerity. Not that you want to impose yourself upon that person. To show him you are inferior and I am superior. No, no, no. Out of sincerity. And out of humility, you call them towards the deen of Allah. So this good sermon will do in the case of common people. Number third level, وَجَادِلْهُمْ بِالَّتِي أَحْسَنُ. There are some people who are paid for taking people astray. The missionaries of the Christians, they are paid for it. The muballighin of Qadianis, they are paid for it. The Muballighin of Baha'is, they are paid for it. They are not going to listen to any sermon, nor are they ready to listen to any arguments. There you have to fight with them, quarrel with them, argue with them. This is called Mujadala, from Jadl. Jadl means fighting. But verbal fighting, Munazara, Mubahala, as this word came in Surah Al Imran. So this level also, third level, you have to argue with them and defeat them in their arguments. But here also, your attitude should be very good, not bad. You shouldn't call names. You shouldn't go low. You should retain a level, a moral level. وَجَادِلْهُمْ بِالَّتِي أَحْسَنْ Even if you have to argue against them, but it should be in a very, very good way, beautiful way. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنْ ضَلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ Surely your Lord very well knows who has gone astray from his path. وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِالْمُهْتَدِينَ And he knows very well those who are rightly guided. فَإِنْ عَاقَبْتُمْ But if you have to take revenge, now if your opponents are calling names to you, they are persecuting you, doing some harm to you, and now if you decide that you have to take revenge, in عَاقَبْتُمْ فَعَاقِبُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا عُوقِبْتُمْ بِهِ Then punish them only with the like of that with which they were afflicted. You were afflicted this much. So that much only can you afflict them, not more than that. So you have to be equal. Whatever harm they did to you, you can take the revenge to that extent, but not more. فَإِنْ عَاقَبْتُمْ فَعَاقِبُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا عُوقِبْتُمْ بِهِ وَلَئِنْ صَبَرْتُمْ لَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لِلْصَابِرِينَ But if you endure patiently, don't take revenge. Because you know this is a Makki surah. During the Makki period, this was the order of the day for all the 12 long years. That, O Muslims, no retaliation from your side. Take all the persecution patiently, whether it is verbal persecution or it is physical persecution. But you are not to retaliate, no retaliation whatsoever. So that is also given here. Wala in sabartum. If you take it patiently, pocket it, and don't take revenge, لَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لِلْصَابِرِينَ It is much better than for those who persevere and who endure patiently. وَاسْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ And endure you also, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَاسْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ And your patience is only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Due to his support, because you have put your trust in him. وَلَا تَحْزَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ And don't grieve on them, because now they are doomed. Now that you have taken about 12 years in calling them to the right path, to Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they have rejected you. So Allah's chastisement will come to them. But then you should not grieve over it, because they are your kith and kin. They are your own tribe. You belong to Quraysh. You are a Qarshi. They are your kith and kin and your relatives. But don't grieve on them. وَلَا تَكُ فِي زَيْقٍ مِمَّا يَمْكُرُونَ And also, don't be straitened in your hearts and chest due to what they are conspiring. They are conspiring against you. They are plotting against you. They are having mutual consultations that we should kill Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We should murder him. All these things they are doing. But you don't think that they can do anything. So, وَلَا تَكُوْ فِي زَيْقٍ مِمَّا يَمْكُرُونَ Whatever plotting they are doing, whatever conspiracies they are hatching, they will do no harm to you. وَلَا تَكُوْ فِي زَيْقٍ مِمَّا يَمْكُرُونَ Don't be very fearful of these things. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with those people who have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the due regard of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مُحْسِنُونَ And who are excellent in worship and service of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is with you, so you need not worry. Let them conspire. Let them plot. Let them make schemes. Don't worry, because Allah is with you. And this was the word that the Prophet said to Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when they were both hiding in that cave of Sawr, and people had just reached, you know, at the mouth of that cave. And Abu Bakr said radiallahu ta'ala anhu, only if they cast their eyes towards their own feet, they will see us. What was the answer? La tahzan, inna Allah ma'ana. Don't grieve. Allah is verily allies with us. So this is it. Inna Allah ma'al ladina attaqaw, wal ladina hum muhsinun. Let them conspire, let them plot, whatever they want, what intrigues they want to do. You don't worry. We are with you. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع العليم صدق الله العظيم إنه هو السميع البصير sorry سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده glorified is he who took his bondsman his servant محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم by night, min al-masjid al-haram, from the sacred mosque, that is, of Makkah, ila al-masjid al-aqsa, to the remote mosque, that is, which was in Jerusalem, alladhi barakna hawlahu, whose environment and neighborhood we have blessed, linuriyahu min ayatina, so that we show to him, to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our signs. Innahu huwa as-sami'ul basir. Verily, he is all listening, all seeing. وَآتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ وَجَعَلْنَاهُ هُدًى لِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ. And we gave Moses, alayhi salatu wassalam, al-kitab, Torah, the book. وَجَعَلْنَاهُ هُدًى لِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ. And we declared it, made it, a guidance for the children of Israel. Now note the difference. Torah was guidance for Bani Israel only, not for the whole of humanity. While Quran is hudal linnas, wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal-furqan. Shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran, hudal linnas, wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal-furqan. It is the guidance for all mankind, for whole human race. Wa atayna Musa al-kitaba wa ja'alna hudal li Bani Israel. Allah tattakhizu min duni wakila. The essence of the teaching of Torah was, don't take anybody, guardian, by my side, alongside me. You should trust me. You should put all the trust in me, not trusting anybody else, not relying on anybody else. Not hoping help from anybody else. Allah tattakhidhu min duni wakila. Take not any guardian beside me. Zurriyata man hamalna ma'anuh. You are the progeny of those people who we had carried in that, you know, kishti? Ark, yes. With Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam. Innahu kana abdan shakura. Verily, Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam was our bondsman, our servant, and a very grateful servant. وَقَضَيْنَا إِلَىٰ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ فِي الْكِتَابِ لَتُفْسِدُنَّ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَّتَيْنِ وَلَتَعْلُنَّ عُلُوًا كَبِيرًا. And we had decided and declared for the children of Israel in the book, you will certainly do mischief in the earth twice, and you will certainly rise to the height of insolence and arrogance and tyranny. Now, please let me give you a view, a review, let me say it, of the history. Because here, in this first section of Surah Bani Israel, the history of Bani Israel is being referred to. The history of the former Muslim Ummah starts from the year nearly 1400 BC. When Torah was given to Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. But their rise to power and glory, that was about 400 years later. Not the case with us. Our Khilafat-e-Rashida, the pious caliphate, was just adjacent to the period of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But there was 3 or 4 centuries gap between Moses and their glorious time. The glorious time was the reign of Talut alayhi salam, Dawood alayhi salam, and Sulaiman alayhi salam. 3 kings, about 100 years, 1000 BC to 900 BC. After Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, the kingdom broke into 2. The northern kingdom of Israel, the capital was Samaria. And southern kingdom of Judea, Yehuda, and its capital was Jerusalem. But then there was the downfall. These people just threw the book and Sharia of Allah on their backs, turned away from the Sharia. They were loving this world and its luxuries, etc., etc. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them the chastisement, the punishment in this world. First of all, the northern kingdom, Israel, was destroyed by Assyrians in the year 731 before Christ. And then after that day, you know, Israel came into existence in 1948, in this century. Between these two, there never has been any Israel. Israel was the northern kingdom, which was destroyed in the year 731 before Christ. And then, you know, Yehuda, that was also destroyed by Nebuchadnezzar in the year 587 before Christ. Hundreds and thousands of people were massacred. Hundreds and thousands of people were taken as captives to Babylonia. Not a single soul remained in Jerusalem. Not 2 bricks remained intact. The temple, we should call it mosque. They call it temple. Solomon's temple, temple of Solomon, it was the mosque. Built by Hazrat Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. But it was raised to the ground by Nebuchadnezzar. Demolished. But then, after some time, this kingdom of Babylonia was destroyed by Cyrus, the king of Persia. Khoras or Cyrus and Zulkarnain, who is mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf in the Quran. And we shall read it, inshallah, tomorrow. So when he destroyed Babylonia, he then allowed Jews to go back. But they didn't come en bloc, only trickled down, coming, some people coming, others stayed back there. And then Darius, who was the next king after Cyrus, then he helped them to go back. And they came with Hazrat Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam in the year 458 BC. Now another period started for them. And that was the period of second glory. A Maccabi empire was established. Because due to the reformationary work which was done by Hazrat Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam, the people again apologized to Allah, repented to Allah, they rectified their manners, they started practicing the Sharia. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again gave them a chance. Again there was a rise. Again they had a, you know, power and glory in this world. And that was the Maccabi kingdom, which as far as the area is concerned, it was greater than the kingdom of Solomon, Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. But then, again there was a downfall. Again they forgot about the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again they were after the worldly gains and the earthly pleasures and lusts. So again, you know, then they were punished at the hands of the, first at the hands of the Greek, Alexander and Seleucus, then at the hands of the Romans, and they were under the Romans actually, although the Romans had put a king, local king here in Judea, and he was Herod the Great. But actually, the governing force was, and the garrison, the Roman garrison was there. This is the history. Two rises, two falls. One rise to glory, during that is the pinnacle was, the days of Talut, Dawood, and Suleiman, alayhi salatu wasalam. Then the downfall, and this lower crest was, number one, destruction of Israel at the hands of Assyrians, 731 BC. And then the destruction of Judah at the hands of Nebuchadnezzar, and demolition of the first temple, 587 BC. Then there was a revival in them, a revival, a renaissance. And then they had a Maccabi power again. They rose to height and power. But again, second downfall. And that downfall, you know, the lowest ebb was when in the year 70, Titus, a Roman general, massacred 133,000 Jews in one day in Jerusalem. And then another 63,000 taken as captives, slaves. And the Jews were ordered to go away from Palestine. Their period of diaspora started. Some went to Europe, others to Asia, others to Africa, diaspora. Diaspora started from the year 70 AD, and it ended in the year 1917, after the Balfour Declaration, when the British, under the British mandate, Balfour declared, he was the Foreign Secretary of British Empire, that Jews can come back to Palestine and they can settle there. So this period from 70 AD to 1917, it was their diaspora. And then in 1948, their state of Israel was established. In 1967, they, you know, increased their area by capturing the Sinai Peninsula from the Egyptians, the Golan Heights from the Syrians, and the West Bank, whole of it, from Jordan. And this is the dispute which is going on now. We don't know what form it will take, but it can flare up at any time into a very big war, very big war, very big war. And Suratul Kahf starts with a prophecy that a very big war will come. But that we shall read tomorrow. Now come to the text. وَقَضَيْنَا إِلَىٰ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ فِي الْكِتَابِ لَتُفْسِدُنَّ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَّتَيْنِ وَلَتَعْلُنَّ عُلُوًّا كَبِيرًا. And we had forewarned the children of Israel that you will certainly make mischief, great mischief in the earth twice. And you will certainly rise to the height of arrogance and tyranny. فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعَدُ أُولَاهُمَا. So when the promise of the first of the two came to pass, بَاسْنَا عَلَيْكُمْ عِبَادَ لَنَا أُولِي بَاسٍ شَدِيدٍ. We sent over you our bondsmen who were very tough in fighting. فَجَاسُوا خِيَالَ الدِّيَارِ. They permeated all of your lands and ravaged. وَكَانَ وَعَدَ مَفْعُولًا. And our promise had to come to be true. The promise was done. You were punished. These were the at the hands of Nebuchadnezzar. I told you, if I am not, you know, making an error, 600,000 were massacred. 600,000 were taken captive to Babylonia. Not a single soul remained in Jerusalem. And not even two bricks were intact. And the temple, the mosque built by Suleiman alayhi salatu wasalam was raised to the ground. Summa radadna lakumul karrata alayhim. Then we gave back your turn over them. This is the Maccabi, their renaissance. They again rose to height. Summa radadna lakumul karrata alayhim wa amdadnakum bi amwalin wa banina. And we helped you with sons and wealth. Wa ja'alnakum aksara nafira. And we made you very numerous in numbers. In ahsantum, ahsantum li anfusikum. If you did something good, you did it for yourself. Wa in asatum, fala. If you have done something bad, evil, well, it is against you. You will have to suffer. فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعَدُ الْآخِرَةِ When the time of the second promise came to pass, this is year 70 after Christ, 70 AD, not BC now, after Christ. Because Christ was raised to the heaven in the year 32 AD. Because Christ was born in 1 BC. You know, this fallacy you must be knowing, that you know the calendar, the Christian calendar is as a mistake. Because Christ was born, according to their tradition, on the 25th of December. And they started 1 year from 1st January, which followed it. So actually, Christ was born 1 year before Christ. Because the era, Christian era is starting from the 1st January, 6 days after the birth of Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam. Anyhow, 32. Because he was aged at that time, 33. That was the age of Christ. Alayhi salatu wasalam, and he was raised to the heavens. فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعَدُ الْآخِرَةِ لَيَسُوءُ وُجُوهَكُمْ Again we sent over you hordes, armies, so that they may disgrace your faces. وَلَيَدْخُلُوا الْمَسْجِدَ كَمَا دَخَلُوهُ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ And they may enter the mosque, masjid. Quran is saying masjid, temple. The second temple which was built during the Maccabi power. This was the second temple, which is now lying raised to the ground. Except only a wall, the wailing wall, the western wall of this second temple is intact. And the Jews go there and mourn and weep, just like, you know, Shias, as they, you know, do mourning, they also do this same type of mourning in the wall, wailing wall. They call it the wailing wall, where they go and weep and mourn. So they entered the mosque again as they had entered during the first time. وَلَيُتَبِّرُوا مَا عَلَوْا تَتْبِيرًا And so that they should destroy on everything, destroy everything that they laid their hands upon, destroy everything that they conquered. أَسَى رَبُّكُمْ أَنْ يَرْحَمَكُمْ Your Lord is still ready to have mercy upon you. These people, Bani Israel, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala twice says in Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ اسْكُرُوا نِعْمَتِيَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَأَنِّي فَضَّلْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ I raised you higher than all the nations of the world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had been very, very, very kind to them. Very kind to them. No doubt. So here again, after all their mischiefs and the misdoings, what they had been doing, they tried to crucify a messenger of Allah, Jesus alayhi salatu wasalam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not as yet destroyed them. Their chastisement, Azabul Akbar, has not come to them, which came to the people of Nuh, which came to the nation of Hud, which came to the nation of Saleh. This is yet to come, and it will come, and it is not very far off. But up till this time, Asa Rabbukum an yarhamakum. It is being said when Quran was revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam 1400 years ago. Your Lord is ready to have mercy upon you even now. Wa in udtum udna. But if you repeat, you do the same which you have been doing before, we shall do again the same which we have been doing before. We shall punish you again. Wa ja'alna jahannama lil kafirina hasira. And we have made hell the prison for the disbelievers. إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِيهَا أَقْوَمْ This Qur'an is now guiding humanity to the path which is the straightest, most straight, أَقْوَمْ وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ And gives glad tidings to the believers, الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ Who do good deeds also, أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا That for them there is a very big reward. وَأَنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ As for those who don't believe in resurrection and the hereafter, أَعْتَدْنَا لَهُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا We have prepared for them a very painful chastisement. وَيَدْعُ الْإِنسَانُ بِالشَّرِّ دُعَاهُ بِالْخَيْرِ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا And man, when he is praying for something good, he prays for something which is harmful for him because he is very hasty. We find in Surah Al-Baqarah, أَسَانْ تُحِبُّ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَأَسَانْ تَكْرَهُ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. It's just possible, O people, that you might like something, but in reality it is harmful for you. It's just possible that you might hate something, dislike something, but in reality it might be beneficial for you. So when man prays for him, he thinks, according to his thought, he is asking for something good. But actually what he is asking is not good for him. It is harmful for him. وَيَدُوا الْإِنسَانُ بِالشَّرِّ دُعَاهُ بِالْخَيْرِ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا. Due to this hastiness and short-sightedness, we can't see, you know, beyond certain things. So immediate effect, whether it's pleasure or it's pain, immediate pleasure, we are influenced by that. وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ آيَتَيْنِ. And we have made the light and the day two signs. فَمَحَوْنَا آيَةَ اللَّيْلِ. We have darkened the sign of night. وَجَعَلْنَا آيَةَ النَّهَارِ مُبْصِرَةً. And we have made the sign of day bright, through which you can see. لَتَبْتَغُوا فَضْلًا مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. So that you seek the bounty from your Lord. You earn your livelihood in the day. وَلَتَعْلَمُوا عَدَدَ السِّنِينَ وَالْحِسَابِ. Or so that you know the counting of the years and the reckoning of time. وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ فَصَّلْنَاهُ تَفْصِيلًا. And everything we have explained and expounded in full detail. وَكُلَّ إِنسَانٍ أَلْزَمْنَاهُ طَائِرَهُ فِي عُنُقِهِ. And to every man we have tied his deeds, the balance sheet of his deeds, to his neck. وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And we take it out on the day of judgment. يَلْقَاهُ كِتَابًا يَلْقَاهُ مَنْشُورًا. It will be a book, and he will find it, that it is spread wide, open. اِقْرَى كِتَابَكْ. It will be said, now you yourself read your book, the record of your deeds, misdeeds or good deeds. كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا. You are yourself sufficient for reckoning. And you see what good deeds you have done, and what bad crimes you have committed. You can yourself decide what should be your fate. مَنِ اِهْتَدَى فَإِنَّمَا يَهْتَدِي لِنَفْسِهِ. Whosoever takes to the right path, well, he takes to the right path for his own benefit. وَمَنْ ضَلَّ فَإِنَّمَا يَضِلُّ عَلَيْهَا. And whosoever goes astray, well, he goes astray against himself. You know, he will be the loser on the day of judgment and in the life hereafter. وَلَا تَذِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. And no soul will be able to take the burden of other souls. Every soul, every human being will have to carry his own burden of deeds, maybe of sins. Nobody will be able to come to your help that you are overburdened, let me share with you. No. لَا تَذِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَزِّمِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. And we have not been sending the chastisement, final chastisement, except when we had sent the messenger. This is very important, you know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has never destroyed a nation without first sending a messenger to them, so that the messenger should warn them, call them to the right path, so that they can't say that we didn't know. The message was not conveyed to us. No. But this is done, everything done. And then they reject the messenger. They don't accept him. Then the nations were. Because now I am using this word. Why? Because now no Rasul is to come. No messenger after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that type of punishment, annihilation, you know, as if the nation never existed. لَمْ يَغْنَوْ فِيهَا. As if they were not there. لَمْ يَغْنَوْ فِيهَا. So this chastisement only came after a messenger. وَإِذَا أَرَدْنَا أَنْ نُهْلِكَ قَرْيَةً. And when we decide that some town is going to be destroyed, أَمَرْنَا مُتْرَفِيهَا, then we allow the affluent people of that township, فَفَسَقُوا فِيهَا, and they transgress in that town. They break all the limits of Sharia and decency. فَحَقَّ عَلَيْهِ الْعَذَابِ. And so the world is justified against them. And then, فَدَمَّرْنَاهَا تَدْبِيرًا. And then we annihilate them with complete annihilation. وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا مِنَ الْقُرُونِ مِنْ بَعْدِ نُوحِ. And so many nations and so many races we destroyed after the nation of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. وَكَفَى بِرَبِّكَ بِذُنُوبِ عِبَادِهِ خَبِيرًا بَصِيرًا. And your Lord is sufficient to be aware of the sins of his bondsmen. He knows what has earned what sins. مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ الْعَاجِلَةَ. These ayat are very important, very decisive. مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ الْعَاجِلَةَ عَجَّلْنَا لَهُ فِيهَا مَا نَشَاءُ لِمَنْ نُرِيدُ. Whosoever amongst you, he loves عَاجِلَةَ. عَاجِلَةَ, which is near, immediate, this life, this is عَاجِلَةَ. Dunya and ajila is one. Akhira is the hereafter. Ajila and opposed to ajila, akhira. Dunya and opposed to dunya, akhira. For akhira, one word, akhira. But for dunya, we have dunya as well as ajila. Man kana yuridul ajilata. Whosoever desires this hasty world, ajjalna lahu fiha ma nashau liman nurid. We give them in this world, hastily, whatsoever we decree, to whomsoever we wish. Not that all that you want will be given to you, but we will give you something. If you are working hard for this world, to gain the wealth of this world, well, okay, we shall give, reward you. Some of your, you know, hard labor will be repaid. Summa jalna lahu jahannam. And then after that, we shall appoint for them the hell. يَصْلَاهَا مَذْمُومًا مَدْحُورًا. And he will enter it, despised and rejected. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةَ. And whosoever aims at akhira, likes akhira, desires the hereafter, وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا. And he has strived for it, as one should strive for akhira. How precious is this akhira? You have to work hard for that. This world, temporary abode, and you are working so hard for it. So now imagine how much harder you should work for that eternal life. Sa'alaha sa'yaha. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةَ وَسَعَلَهَا سَعْيَهَا وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. And he is a believer. فَأُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. They are the people. They are striving, shall be appreciated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and rewarded. كُلَّا نُمِدُّ هَا أُولَاءِ وَهَا أُولَاءِ مِنْ أَطَاءِ رَبِّكَ. As for this world, all we are sustaining all. These also, those also. People who desire this world, they also. And people who desire the next world, they also. We give them the sustenance in this world. كُلَّا نُمِدُّ هَا أُولَاءِ وَهَا أُولَاءِ مِنْ أَطَاءِ رَبِّكَ. And this is from the bestowment of your Lord. وَمَا كَانَ عَطَاءُ رَبِّكَ مَحْزُورًا. And the bestowment of your Lord cannot be stopped. انظر كيف فضلنا بعضهم على بعض. In this world also, just look how we have made some people excel others. Some have more wealth, some have less. Some have better health, some have weaker, physique, and so on and so forth. So there is tafsil. انظر كيف فضلنا بعضهم على بعض. Here also in this world, some excel others. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ أَكْبَرُ دَرَجَاتٍ. But the hereafter, it is much greater in ranks, وَأَكْبَرُ تَفْزِيلًا, and much greater in excellence. لَا تَجْعَلْ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرًا. Don't set up with Allah any other God. فَتَقُدَ مَزْمُومًا مَخْزُولًا. Then you will have to sit despised and forsaken. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And your Lord has decided, that you should not worship anybody except Him. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be kind to your parents. Now these ayat, we shall not be able to finish them, complete them, but they are actually the Quranic version of the 10 commandments of Torah. This is the hadith of Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that these ayat, 18 ayat, of these sections, section 3 and 4 of Surah Bani Israel, they are the Quranic version of the 10 commandments of Torah. Commandment number 1, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ اللَّهَ تَعْبُدُ إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. Your Lord has decreed and decided once for all, don't worship anybody else except Allah. Number 2, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Be gentle and respectful and kind to your parents. إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا وَكِلَاهُمَا. If one of them, one of your parents, father or mother, or both of them, reach the age of old age, then don't even say any disrespectful word to them. فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ. Not saying any disrespectful word. وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا. Don't shout on them. وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. And you should say to them, talk to them in a very respectful manner. وَقْفِرْ لَهُمَا جَنَاهَ ذُلَّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ. And lower down your arms and shoulders before them, out of mercy. وَقُرْ. And pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. Oh my Lord, have mercy upon them, my parents, my father and mother, just as they brought me up when I was a very small infant. I was dependent upon them. They brought me up. I cannot give them the reward of, you know, the good that they did to me. Only I can pray to you. You please reward them. وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. رَبُّكُمْ عَلَمُ بِمَا فِي نُفُوسِكُمْ. Your Lord very well knows what is in your hearts. إِن تَكُونُوا صَالِحِينَ. If you are pious and good-intentioned, فَإِنَّهُ كَانَ لِلَوَّابِينَ غَفُورًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving for those who turn to Him. وَآتِ ذَا الْقُرْبَى حَقَّهُ. And give to your relatives, kith and kin, their right. It's a right on you to support them, help them if they are needy. وَآتِ ذَا الْقُرْبَى حَقَّهُ وَالْمِسْكِينَ. And the needy, وَابْنَ السَّبِيلِ, and the wayfarer, traveler. وَلَا تُبَزِّ تَبْزِيرًا. And don't squander away your wealth in squandering. إِنَّ الْمُبَزِّرِينَ كَانُوا إِخْوَانَ الشَّيَاطِينَ. These squanderers of their money, they are the brothers of Satan's. وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِرَبِّهِ كَفُورًا. And verily, the Satan was very ungrateful to his Lord. وَإِمَّا تُعْرِضَنَّ عَنْهُمْ ابْتِغَاءَ رَحْمَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكَ تَرْجُوهَا فَقُلْ لَهُمْ قَوْلًا مَيْسُورًا. And you, if you have to turn away from them while they are asking for some help, and you can't offer any help because you are yourself waiting for the mercy of Allah, that Allah may give you. You are also in need at that time. You can't help them. But then you must say to them gentle words. Don't say some harsh words to them. Apologize. Brother, at this time, it's impossible for me to help you. That way. Not that you are harsh to them. وَإِمَّا تُعْرِضَنَّ عَنْهُمْ ابْتِغَاءَ رَحْمَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكَ تَرْجُوهَا فَقُلْ لَهُمْ قَوْلًا مَيْسُورًا. وَلَا تَجْعَلْ يَدَكَ مَغْلُولَةً إِلَىٰ عُنُقِكَ. And don't make your hand change to your neck. This is actually, this denotes miserliness. Your hand is tied here. It cannot give anything to anybody. So this is the miserliness. وَلَا تَجْعَلْ يَدَكَ مَغْلُولَةً إِلَىٰ عُنُقِكَ. وَلَا تَبْسُطْهَا كُلَّ الْبَسْطِ. And in the same way, don't outspread it totally. Open. You are spending and spending and spending and not seeing to your own needs. So that is also an extreme phenomenon which is not required. وَلَا تَجْعَلْ يَدَكَ مَغْلُولَةً إِلَىٰ عُنُقِكَ وَلَا تَبْسُطْهَا كُلَّ الْبَسْطِ فَتَقْعُدَ مَلُومًا مَحْسُورًا. Maybe if you continue in that way, then you will have to sit down reproached and maybe in severe poverty. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. Verily, your Lord, He widens the risk and the provisions for whomsoever He likes. among his swordsmen, and he straightens them also, less, to some more, to some less. And this is the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِعِبَادِهِ خَبِيرٌ بَصِيرًا. He, with his bondsmen, his servants, he is all-knowing, all-seeing, and aware of everything. وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ خَشْيَةَ إِمْلَاقٍ. And don't kill or murder your offsprings for fear of poverty. نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُهُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ. We shall feed them and also you. We are feeding you. Don't think you are feeding yourself. We are providing for you. We shall provide for you and for them also. إِنَّ قَتْلَهُمْ كَانَ خِطًا كَبِيرًا. Surely, killing the offspring was a very great sin. وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. And don't approach adultery. إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَةً وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. This adultery is definitely a big indecency and an evil way. وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. And don't kill the human life which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared to be respectful, except with law. When law requires, when somebody has killed someone, well, in punishment he can be, his life can be taken, and so on and so forth. وَمَنْ قُتِلَ مَظْلُومًا. And whosoever is killed without any fault of his, فَقَدْ جَعَلْنَا لِوَلِيِّهِ. So we have given the authority to his heir that he can kill the killer. فَلَا يُسْرِفِ الْقَتْلِ. But in taking that revenge and qisas, he should not exceed the limits. إِنَّهُ كَانَ مَنْصُورًا. He will be helped. This society will help that person whose father or brother has been killed by somebody to take the revenge from the person who has killed. إِنَّهُ كَانَ مَنْصُورًا. It's the duty of the society and the state to help get hold of that person killer, and then, you know, put him at the mercy of the heirs of the person who was killed. If they like, they can pardon him. If they like, they can receive some money, blood money, and spare his life. And if they think that no, we need life for life, then if the authority is in their hands. وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا مَالَ الْيَتِيمَ إِلَّا بِالَّتِيهِ أَحْسَنُ. And don't go near the wealth of an orphan, but in the best way. حَتَّى يَبْلُغَ أَشُدَّهُ. Till such time that he attains maturity. وَعَفُوا بِالْأَحْدُ. And fulfill your covenants. And you know, إِنَّ الْأَحْدَ كَانَ مَسْئُولًا. The covenants and contracts, they will be questioned about. وَعَفُوا الْكَيْلَ إِذْ عَقِلْتُمْ. And fill up the measure when you are measuring for others. وَزَنُوا بِالْقِسْطَاسِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. And when you have to weigh something, weigh with a straight balance. ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَحْسَنُ تَعْوِيلًا. This is fair and better in the consequence, in the end. وَلَا تَخْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. And don't pursue for which you have no knowledge. This ayah is very important, but now the time is finished. I will explain this ayah to some length tomorrow, inshallah. But here only we are translating. Don't pursue that thing for which you have no knowledge. Verily, these faculties of samaat, that you can listen, and basara, that you can see, and fuad, again, let me say, the faculty of inferring, which is inherent here in this computer which is placed in your skull. Kullu ulaika kana anhu masula. Everybody will be held responsible for these things. We gave you all these faculties, and you just didn't use them. And you were after such things which have no basis in knowledge. وَلَا تَمْشَ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا. And don't walk on the land, on earth, haughtily. إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَخْرِقَ الْأَرْضِ. You cannot, you will not be able to tear apart our land. وَلَنْ تَبْلُغَ الْجِبَالَ طُولًا. And you will not be able to reach the height of the mountains. Howsoever, you know, you straighten your neck, but you can't reach the height of the mountains. كُلُّ ذَلِكَ كَانَ سَيِّئُهُ إِنْدَ رَبِّكَ مَكْرُوهًا. All of that, the evil thereof is hateful in the sight of your Lord. ذَلِكَ بِمَّا أَوْحَى إِلَيْكَ رَبُّكَ مِنَ الْحِكْمَةِ. This is that which your Lord has revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mean from hikmah. This is the wisdom. This is the basis of a just society, of a healthy society. This is the basis of a social order. ذَلَكَ مِمَّا أَوْحَى إِلَيْكَ رَبُّكَ مِنَ الْحِكْمَةِ This is what your Lord has revealed to you from hikmah, from the wisdom. وَلَا تَجْعَلْ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرًا Don't appoint another God with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَتُلْقَى فِي جَهَنَّمَ مَلُومًا مَدْحُورًا Then you will be cast into the hell, reproved and blameworthy. Last ayah, أَفَأَصْفَاكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ بِالْبَنِينَ Has your Lord Allah favored you with sons, but تَخَذَ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنَاسًا And he has taken for himself the angels as daughters. إِنَّكُمْ لَتَقُولُونَ قَوْلًا عَظِيمًا It's a very awful saying that you are saying. It's something which is very awful. Refrain from it. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات وذكر الحكيم
الله أكبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.